movie I'm making for Facebook. I see my clock.
There's 1:11. In the corner, see the clock. How long is it going to be 1:11 for? There you go. See? Now it's 11, 1, 12.
be to save the world. The world, not the earth. That's just what you care about that you're trying to save. You're not trying to save the earth. You're trying to save the world. Everything that matters to you is the world. World is what's destroying you and the earth. But you know what? It was meant to be this way. Sad. I had a pretty good time. It's just a movie about what Insultica really does. It's going to be on their very seashides at times. Beta, which is actually now just called Jonathan Wildstock Productions, but the main title for it to be found is still the Reezy Shies of Times Beta. And it's going to be on my Facebook page too, but I'm going to post this movie on my company website on Facebook. I'm willing to hire one person, but because of time sink or Freemasons, I'm not saying who. I'm not going to hire them. There's going to be no employees. I'm basically Santa Claus with what I created or could have been. I could have given everybody everything they wanted. But you're all too corrupt. So, my last time I was alive here, I guess I didn't do what you wanted. And you all just bastardized everything I did until I came back. And now here I am, I'm back. And it's just like, how do you expect me to fix this? Just leave it alone, I guess, from now on. Really, I mean, haven't you done enough? It's in the movie, like a fictional movie. My questions. So it's like, I'm on camera. I originally filmed myself, but I lost the movie. And I was talking about a whole bunch of things that might have seemed crazy, but they were true. It's just, you know, from a certain point of view, everything's true. So it doesn't really matter if it's true. It just matters if you gave a shit. And I don't know if you would have, but I made the movie and it got destroyed immediately upon being made. My made up wife, Harriet Winslow. Who I confused for somebody else. Sorry about that. The Harriet Winslow experiment went too far. What do you want me to do with my life? I couldn't have a wife. For real, with the way my life is. Lost 10 pounds, 20 pounds maybe, so I only eat one meal a day. I don't like eating a lot. bought this off of a dead lady who is for sure dead by now. She was alive when I bought it, but she had multiple sclerosis or something. And she asked me not to take it out of the box, but I was just like, yeah, sure, I won't take it out of the box. But I'm like, I took it out of the box. Not to be mean. It's just like, I'm not giving it away. I'm selling it. Keeping it forever. At least I remember that lady. I'm not just somebody who bought it and goes, eh, whatever. I remember the lady's dead. I saw a picture of her. She needed money because she lives in the stupid United States where they don't pay for medicine. They gotta pay like top dollar down there for medicine and shit, and the government doesn't pay for it. It's stupid. I could never imagine having to live in the United States. It'd be horrible. This is what I do all day. I just sit and stare at nothing. I never thought to make movies, but I have a production company, so I'm starting to make movies. And so this is a movie. Why can't the movie be about real life? For real this time. Here it is. Here's real life. This is it. You enjoy it? Is it good? Is it a good show? Yeah. It's on. That's all that matters. I guess I can predict this show. And I'm like, I agree with what this guy's saying. And it's just me on TV. I can see why all those chicks fuck me now. I'm just trying to see if I actually deserve it. I'm a redneck. That's what it is. But I'm not a redneck. It's just I look like a redneck. I think that's what everyone meant by that now. Like, I don't, I'm so unfamiliar with how I look. I do think that's another guy pretending to be me. If I really was God, that'd be nice for like 2 seconds, and then I'd realize I don't have a God. I want a God. I know I'm not God. I know what God is. I want there to be a God instead of to be God. I don't care what he tells me to do. I'm not going to do it all the time. And that's the lucky thing about Jesus. He forgives you. It's just that not everyone will. It's just Jesus will. And sometimes people don't realize because they never get to the point where they have nothing but Jesus, that it is enough. But no one really wants to get to the point where they realize it's enough. So they all forgot because times got too good. Jesus was a good guy to have around and talk about. I mean, just because the Catholic Church did bad stuff, you can't really blame Jesus for it. It's not his fault. People did that sort of stuff. Should have really learned about that guy. I was never really a big Christian or anything. I'm not into the Jewish part of the religion at all. And I don't really like celebrating holidays. Because I know they're pagan, mostly anyways. But I think that in Revelations, when he was talking about the whore of Babylon, Ishtar, Easter, he was right. This is the worst person there ever was. Because it's not. There's no such thing. And if that's how Jesus wants to be, then there is no such thing as a Prince of Peace or anything like that. Jesus hates people so bad he wants them to die, he says in Revelations. In a book of hatred, basically, is all it is. That might have been the reason why 9/11 happened, more than Easter. Actually, it might have been Jesus' fault that all that happened. Jesus Christ might have been the reason why 9/11 and all the years past 9/11 have gone exactly as the 2,000 years went, like he said they would. The two twins fell. I'm sure there's stuff about King Solomon was in the devil, Antichrist. The Jews, the Romans. You know. And Jesus is here. After about 600 million people had died because they fucked with him. And he's wondering, are you ever going to learn? Are you ever gonna learn? Thank you.